Welcome to another Turning Tuesday. This week I am doing minimal voiceovers and it is a long video. There is three bowls made throughout this video. Some mistakes, some UFOs, and some definite fun things to look out for. So keep your eyes peeled and let me know your favorite bit. Now, in saying that, one of the bowls, I thought I was recording. I was not. So, you'll see that I mount one of the bowls up, and then all of a sudden, I'm sanding. The reason for that is I got it all set up, and then went, how about I go sharpen? And so I turned the cameras off, I went and sharpened. I came back, and I forgot to hit record again. So, it's got 90% of the bowl being made. Unfortunately, the coring out of the center is not captured. However, that one wasn't the best. So, either way, we've still got some amazing footage, and I really hope you enjoy. Starting off strong with the bandsaw, moving into the drill, and from there we will do the exteriors. I set this up as a production line over the long weekend. I did these bowls over 3 days, and yeah, so basically did the bandsaw the first day, I did drilling and exteriors the second day, and then I corded out on the third. So I hope you enjoy, and as always, if you've got feedback, please let me know.
So, I'm going to bring you in and go over some of the troubleshooting steps that I did. One was rebalancing the lathe because it was out of round, so it wasn't square, it wasn't working very well. Now, Sid's recommendation was give it a free spin and see if we end up about back at the same spot. Giving it a free spin, and as you can see, it rocks itself back to almost the exact same spot. So we'll do it again, just to prove that it's not insanity, did it again. Let's put that spot right at the top. Stayed still. Little bump, little bump, little bump, little bump, little bump. Come on. There it goes. And takes itself straight back down, which says either something's lopsided or there is additional weight or density in this piece of wood. To rule out anything mechanical, our next troubleshooting step was check if the spindle was round. So what I did was put this bad boy off. Took it off and I brought the tool rest in to rest the tool rest against it because I don't have any fancy whiz bang measuring anything. I have a very modest lathe with a very modest workshop. It's quite literally a one car garage and only one. Two-fifths of it. So, what I wanted to do was get this in here. It's in nice and tight on the edge of the spindle, or the spindle bar. And what I just did was rotated it to see if at any point it either got tighter or looser. And as you can hear by the spinning, well, you might not be able to hear it, but it's doing exactly the same level of firmness against it the whole way around, which means the spindle blank is perfectly fine, which means we're back to the piece of wood. Stepping back to the piece of wood, my next question was density. So, giving that a quick spin back on there, make sure we're locked in. Now, as I mentioned, it had a propensity for this section to end up at the bottom. So, coming in here, what have we got different on this side to anything else? One, we've got these dark patches of the claret ash. We've also got this knot running through. However, the actual heavy part that we noticed was over here a bit more. So, my non-scientific test is the knock test. My ears can hear that as quite dense. Now, I've got a piece on this wood that I know is exceptionally dense, which is right here, and you can tell that because of all the way the grain runs. And it sounds almost identical. Right in the heart of that density, it's actually looser. It doesn't sound as dense. So, what I'm putting it down to is inside this could be some amazing figure, or it's just strangely dense with how I've cut it. Because as you notice, the grain is, it's not a burl, it's not from a crotch section. There was nothing indicating that this was going to be anything spectacular. When I cut it on the bandsaw, I saw the chatoyance coming off, and that was just off the blade, and that chatoyance does go basically all across that heavy half there. So I suspect it's just dense. So we will get back to turning and hopefully not break anything. Thank you.
Thank you.